Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 1-100 Master Grade Astray Blue Frame with Full Weapon Set from Daban, and I got the model kit from Gundam Central. Yeah, the final kit that Daban was going to release, but didn't, but now it is. I don't know how, but that's fine with me. I'm just glad to have it. Another blue frame that apparently killed the third-party company, but we did get it, and it's decent. I do feel that I don't know if this is because of how it was released. I do feel that the detail is not as crisp as I have come to expect. It's a little softer. Not terrible. The stickers were a little poopy, so I didn't get them on the eyes. I tried. And then I also left the ones off the cameras because they're clear green, so I don't see much of a point. And I did glue a few things. I had to glue this part of the bicep on. It wouldn't stay on. I had to glue this shoulder, the two halves together. Every time I moved the arm, it would separate. I glued the V-fin on just because Astray V-fins suck. Always. So I don't want to deal with it. This ball joint here that connects the backpack to the torso comes off very, very easily. I feel there's some other parts I glued, but I can't remember. So no, it wasn't a perfect build, which I wasn't really expecting. And you also get some water slide decals, which is nice. Oh, it was upside down. And it does have the two-tone going forward with the gray and the white. And it does have two-tone blue. You got the normal blue, and then you have the darker blue, which actually is slightly metallic. Has a little bit of a shimmer to it, which I didn't notice originally. And I have the new calf armor pieces, which are for the extra weaponry, which I left on just because there's a lot of specific pressure you had to push in to get these just, like, sandwiched between the legs or around the legs, so I just left them on. Got a little bit of orange on there and clear green. And it's a little wobbly. Not terrible, though. It's a little loose in the ankles on the side to side, but it stands pretty well. So, it's not perfect, but it's okay. So the head is ball-jointed. At the top, it's got the hinge in the bottom. You got the up and down the torso, which is the bottom part of the chest is connected to the bar. And then you can go forward and back. You can rotate. Go out. It's all together that high up. Rotate below the shoulder. I think I had to glue this white part here. I think I had to glue it in. You have a double-jointed elbow. You got a ball-jointed wrist with the fingers they have to swap out. Nothing is articulate on them. You have the forward and back. Is it forward and back? Yeah. Forward and back in the stomach. Very little. It does need to move some, but it does pop out the ball joint in the backpack. You also have the rotation. You got the ball jointed front skirts and hinge side skirts and hinge back skirts, which sometimes separate. Legs will go about that far forward. And that far back. And that far out. And rotate the thigh. You do have a nice double-jointed knee. And then you have the ankle, which is ball-jointed at the top of the joint and at the bottom. And then you have the nice ankle rocker and the toe joint. So, the hips are rather hindered. That's just the way it is. But the ankles definitely make up for it, I'd say. And while it's a little loose here and there, it can still, at least mine, mileage may vary, but it can hold a decent pose. So let's start with the hands. You got the holding hands, which are more for like a katana, which we don't have in this kit. You got the trigger finger hands. You've got open hands, which would hold a sheath, which we don't have in this kit. You've got split open hands, and you've got closed fist hands. Nothing's articulate. You just take the pull the whole fingers out in order to put weapons in. And then we have the Astray shield, which does have the text on it, which does look pretty good. Even though, like I said, the detail seems a little bit more dull. It's not as crisp as the as other kits who do these in metal build. Character point can move. It's on a ball joint and on a double hinge. You also have the extra handle, which I never use. But because of the double hinge here, you can peg into the arm, like so. Oops, and then get it over there, and it's pretty tight, so it'll hold. And then we got the beam saber handles on the backpack, which I'm actually going to take the backpack off because I'll need to later, so it'll just be easier right now. So these will come out, and you have two flat, more neon pink beams, which they fit together very nicely, and they do have the hole. So you could use this one here, which is more for, like I said, the katana. It's a little loose, though. But you can also use the trigger finger hand. I know it sounds weird, but it does have the peg in it. So it would work a little better just pegging it in and then putting the fingers over top of it. The beam rifle, which also has the text on it, Morgan Wright. Got the clear green sensor. Does have a movable handle here. It does look good. It has a two-tone effect on it. It's hard to notice. I think the camera's showing it off better than the naked eye. And it has a peg, which you can't flip out, but if I remember correctly, this is used for the flight pack, which this doesn't have. You don't really need it anyways. But it doesn't have a peg hole in it, so you could just use like the normal kind of holding hands to grasp it. That's the wrong ones. But yeah, it wouldn't be super secure, but it's good enough, I guess. So those are the normal Astray weaponry, which is fine. Now we're getting to the good stuff, and we'll start with the new backpack. So you got some nice orange on here. There's two different hookups on the back, which I'll explain. But it does peg in very nicely because you got the peg here that goes in the middle, and then two tabs on the sides which go into holes in the backpack. Much more secure than the actual normal Astray backpack. It doesn't have to rely on the ball joint down there. You could keep this on there and just have it folded down, but don't really want to. If the ball joint was a better connection down there, I would. So, the two connections here. Well, first off, we'll talk about I love this thing. The bazooka. These bazookas are so cool. They have the chrome, silver, and gold on them. Even for the piston, which, unfortunately, this one here broke. So be careful with that. But you got the chrome barrel, some detail in here, in the back. You got the removable ammo, which has fully colored. Like, would you go to the trouble of coloring your grenades or your rockets? It's like, with the orange, blue. I like it, but it's just kind of silly. Now, they give you two clear, bubbly stickers, which I couldn't find them on the instructions of where to put them, but it would make sense that it's the bazooka, because you get two of them. But I just put the one on, because you get clear green for the sensor, so just to show the difference with the sticker. And these parts here open up. I like the fact that the barrel, you can see inside, it's a different color. That's nice. The scope can move. This one, the piston isn't broken, so you can see how it works. Yeah, I pulled it a little too far, I guess, with the other one, and it broke. I glued it, but I don't want to move it. So these can be held in the hands. Now, it's not going to be the trigger finger hands. You'll have to use these hands that are more like... Alright, so it can be a little fiddly to get them in the hands. But once you get them on... And also, I am very concerned about these ball joints snapping, because it's a long tab, and it's a very tight connection. It's a good tight connection, but not so much for swapping the hands with such a long peg. But you can have it holding the bazooka over the shoulder. Works rather nicely. It is a little loose, but if you have it over the shoulder, it's not a big deal, I feel. So that's cool. And because you get two, you can mount the one on this kind of claw connection, which the backpack, it has a ball joint down here and a ball joint connecting to the arm. I don't recommend you move this one, at least on mine. It's super tight. And this one, it will rotate. But you'll notice I switched these around for a reason, because I tried to pull out this connection over here. It broke the ball joint inside. I was thankfully able to push it through, because this is a little cap. I pushed it through the other side, and I was able to put this one. I didn't put it in all the way, because I'm pretty sure if I try to yank this one out, it'll break, and I don't want that to happen again over here. So, yeah, it's annoying. But to put this on here, there's a nonchalant little indent in here. And sorry, not that one. Up here. It looks the same. Right here. And so you just go like that. And now it's stored. So you can have one in the hand. If you don't break the other one, I Gorilla Glue this one on. So it might be okay, but if you don't break one, you can have one on each side, or you can have one bazooka and one missile pod, which comes with their own effect parts. Now, in the instructions, it shows these two ones specifically are made for the bigger missile pods, which have a nice gold chrome on the rim. And you can pull every single one of these missiles is individual. You can actually push this slider here to pull them out, so you can pull them all out easier. But they are all individual, so you don't have to have these two. I have firing, you can have none firing, or different ones. But I just really love that effect. That one's white, that one's not. Not really sure why. Now, it does have a handle, which you can detach. And then you can use one of those two holes, depending on the one side. So you can have one on the backpack, or both. And then you can take the other missile pod, and using the peg, I'm going to take, hopefully I can do this, though something fell off. And there's the blue frame holding the missile pod. It has the peg, which works really, really well with the trigger finger hand that has a peg in it. And I was trying to hold the bazooka in the other hand, but it was just a little too, I feel it works better having the bazooka over here where the other bazooka is instead of the missile pod. Just, it's a little less cluttered, but because of what I broke before, it doesn't quite work for me. Not a huge deal. And then finally, the smaller missile pod, which actually gives you enough effect parts for all three missiles. They are different than the bigger ones. They're a little smaller. It's a little different detail on them. But you don't have to have them firing at all if you don't want. Get a little bit of chrome in there. And they only peg on the legs. I mean, you might be able to put them on there. I haven't tried. Actually, I can try because I have the other connection. Because you get two mounts for the bazookas and two mounts for the missile pods. Alright, you could... Yeah, I guess you could use the little ones if you wanted to. Have the little ones on the... have the hands. You'd have him holding two bazooka, or two of the big ones. And have the little ones above. And there we go. And that works really well, actually. And now there are actually a few things I forgot when I initially recorded this review, so I want to mention them now. The beam rifle, which I talked about how the peg isn't used anymore because you don't have the flight pack. You can still mount it for storage, which I really like in case you have a problem with the any of the hands holding them properly. You get this weird claw-looking thing. Initially, I was like, what is this for? Does it shoot out or something? No. It is ball-jointed, and it holds the actual beam rifle. So it just goes in between where the handle is. There's, once again, a kind of like nondescript little indent with all this detail. It's hard to see. But it is just enough to hold a rifle once you get it in. Well, I should have done this before putting the weapons on. There you go. So now it is stored on the backpack. And it is getting very cluttered back there. And also, you get the metal build stand, which has no font for the name, which I really wish it did. Just very plain. It has all the same kind of articulation like the other ones do. But unfortunately, I thought I had the right connector for it, but I went and saved the one for the flight pack, not the one to mount the crotch. So I can't actually put him on the stand. However, I'm not going to because I don't have any room for a stand. But I just wanted to show it that you do get the stand. It's just kind of boring. But what are you going to do, huh? They just, I mean, the fact that we got the kit at all is a good thing. The hands are a little tricky to hold the bazookas, I find, just because the bazooka doesn't have a peg hole, which would be really, really good, I feel. But it does work for the missile pods, because they do have a peg hole. So you just have to fight a little bit more with the bazookas, but I still really like them. I love the chrome detailing on them. That turned out really good. There's, like, no bubbling that I can see on the chrome. It actually looks nice, and there's not a lot of it, so I think that's why. But yeah, it turned out really, really nice. Be careful with those pistons, like I said. Be careful with these ball joints on the backpack. But yeah, I'm very, very happy with the accessories. So I figured I'd start with the red frame third-party metal build. Actually, I think this is the metal build or the model? I can't remember. But I think that was based off the same figure. Well, same base figure. And then how about an official blue frame? The blue frame, camera was called D, I think it is. Definitely smaller looking. And then the other third-party blue frame, which seemed to destroy another third-party company, the blue frame third. I'm so glad I got both of these. I didn't think I'd ever would. But in the span of less than a year, I got both. So I'm very happy about that. And that is the Daban metal build blue frame with a full equipment set. Very awesome. It does have problems. I'm not sure if it would have as many if it was officially released. Like I said, I feel the detail isn't quite as crisp as it should be. Some of the joints are a little looser than I'd like. Then again, Daban has had problems with that from the get-go, so eh. I love the weapons. They look really good. Be careful with the backpack. And the pistons in the bazookas. Don't go too crazy when you move the handle. But, I mean, I didn't do a lot of gluing on it. And everything went together well enough, and I really like those effect bars that they included those. So if you want to pick the cut up, click the link below to go to Gundam Central, and I'll see you in the next review.